Kia ora whānau. Just thought I'd run through real quick through our setup now before I leave. I actually just finished doing like a 5 minute yarn thinking that it was recording, but it wasn't. Just thought I'd run through all my gear, just do a little introduction to this journey, because I think it will be pretty cool to document, you know, start right through to the finish. Anyway, this is what I got. Got the tripod, got my my knife belt, some vegetables, koi. Got the goody drum, gonna be jamming that up some maungas or around some rivers and creeks. Got the backpack, got all my sleeping gears in there, got this this drum here. That's for our eels. If we catch some eels, Papa wants some eels, so he's gonna set the hinaki. Camera bag, my sleeping flash mattress. In this bag I got my drone. It's pretty much all my camera gears. Got the para lens. That's pretty much it, whānau. So I just thought I would do a little quick little run through before we start heading off on this journey, just to sort of document it and try and create like a bit of a vlog thing out of it. I don't know, I'm not too flash with this stuff, but we'll see how we go. Just seen a couple of pork wandering down into that creek. There we go, there down the bottom. You should have just seen it. Yeah, that's not a bad sized pig too, but it looks like a sow, I think.
There's one in there, that's a bigger one. He's up against that fence line.
Oh, okay.
He's the first one I saw.
Yep.
He's quite a big pig too.
So we've spotted some pork over in the backpack. They're just taking snow and my uncle's kuri. Got Papa and Spider out the back there. Okay, so we pulled over. As you've seen, we spotted those pigs over on that clearing. Everyone was excited. We hatched this plan. Uncle Harry's got this new pup, and she's only a baby. When we pulled her off the back of the truck, she was letting off a few yelps in just excitement. We had a crack at it anyway, whānau. We took off, and this is pretty much what happened. Alright, whānau, as you've probably already just seen, we saw some pigs over on the other side of the paddock, on the bush edge. So we let the dogs off, well, we let Snow off. On our way down there, Uncle Harry's dog did off a few little yelps, and we think that they might have heard us from across the paddock and bolted off. So plan B was Uncle Harry and Pablo have gonna sidle around the face and meet up with me. I'm gonna take the truck and I'm gonna make my way down to where we're gonna be camping, which is just around the corner a bit, and I'm just gonna start setting up camp, whānau, and wait for them to turn up, and who knows. It's probably one of the awesome parts about getting outdoors, whānau, this sort of stuff going through I better make sure I don't drop my phone, but I'll try and get some action for you. Going through. Oh, chicken, wow, that's chicken, wow.
Hope no mattresses fall off the back. We're free, we're free. Woo, we're free. Good shit hanging off. Put the uncle's mattress half hanging off the back there.
You'll be alright, boy. You'll be
alright. Where am I finally? Prepared a bit of a fire. Just got the base all sorted. So that when I get back, just spark it up and we're away. I'm gonna heat up this trek. I'm just gonna walk up there. I know there's a couple of clearings further up, so we'll see if we can bump into a bit of a deer. And I'll try catch it on film. See what happens. See how good the old stalking skills are, right? But here's our camp anyway. Just threw up the tent. Got the tarpaulin in there, but we'll chuck it up later on. Let's go for a little bit of a hunt.
Okay, so my plan is to slowly stalk up to that boulder and take a shot from there, and also get some good footage from there, because that was really, really close to where they are, as you can see. That's probably only about 20 meters away. So I was looking forward to getting to that boulder and then pulling out the camera and getting some really massive footage of those pigs before I took a shot. To get as close as I could to these pigs, so I ended up taking my boots off, I took my oil skin off, I took my belt off, and I just had the camera in one hand and the gun in the other. Okay, So I finally get to the boulder, and what happens? My camera doesn't want to focus. I don't know what was going on. I mucked around with the autofocus thing. I zoomed, I pulled out, I bloody turned it down and tried to focus on something else to try and get it to work, but it just wouldn't work finally. And I sat there for another, felt like a lifetime, because when you're that close to them, it can get quite, you know, you have to take a lot of, you have to take every opportunity that you get, because it can just be over like that. What happens is I decided, well, okay, you know, it's now or never. I've got to take the shot on these pigs. So I gotta go close my camera, and I gotta go switch it off, and it clicks like a, it makes this f-ing clicking noise. As soon as it made that noise, I looked up and these pigs just bolted. They were gone. They were gone. And I was just sitting there like, fuck. It was ratchet. So they bolted off, and I carried on up this track, hoping that I'd bump into them again, but they had veered off, they'd gone off at the side somewhere and into the bush. But I knew there was a few more clearings further up ahead, and if I had seen pigs there, then there was a good chance that I'd bump into something further on up. So this is what happens next. I end up stalking up on a clearing. Now, obviously I was not going to make the same mistake twice. So I put my camera away and I just stalked this clearing and gave it my best shot, just to have a go at an animal if there was one in there. I slowly come over and the wind's coming up from behind me, and I'm thinking, oh, if there is animals out here, they're gonna wind me, and they're gonna bolt as soon as they get a smell of me in the area. I come around, I'm creeping up, like just get to this rise, and these two pigs were just over this little rise and they just bolted off into the bush. And I got my gun and I pulled it up and I was like ready for a shot, but they were moving too fast, and then I lined one up and then it stopped right just inside the bush. I could just see the arse end of this pig. It wasn't a big one, it was probably only about 80 pound, and it stopped there, and it like turned its head like this, and it was trying to hear the danger, because it could only smell me. And because pigs have don't have very good eyesight, they're using their main things are their nose and their ears. So it was trying to hear out for like movement of danger, and I lined them up, and it was a nice young fat, just a nice young fat sow.
Cheer whānau. Here we have our, just portioned up our pork. Nice roasts, and a nice boil up, so. Yeah.
Gotta be one of the nicest pigs I've tasted in a long time, so. Carry on with this video, whānau. There's plenty more stuff in here, and there's a good story coming up too, so I'll keep you updated.
And I just wandered up, carried on down this track a little bit further, and on my bare feet, I went down here. There's another clearing further up that way, and sure enough there was a little mob of deer in there, and I saw a hind and a yearling. And then she was behind this brush, and I thought, oh yeah, I had a mean vantage point. I was going to get like probably 5 meters away from them, 10 meters away from them, because they were on the other side of this big mound. So I was sort of like rushing up, making a move up to this little mound. Fucking, there was a spiker. There was like a spiker just like standing there, like looking at me. And he bolted, and the rest of them gassed it too. So we got a pork. It's day one. My whole reason for going on a plant based is pretty much just a discipline thing, a mental discipline. Wild pork. We'll see how we go. I might have a piece. I haven't had meat in like 4 months, but Ngahire. Ngahire. Powerful, powerful energy. I'll get our fire started. Just get the fire pumping nice and big for when they get back, because they would have had a big walk, especially Papa. He's 76 and he's running around on these hills. Damn, look at that. So anyway, yeah, see you soon. Okay, so we're home. I'm back to the our camp now. There's our truck. There's our tent, chili bin and stuff. My mate's still not back yet. Damn, Ken. My mate still ain't back yet. Oh, no. I thought I heard some footsteps. Yeah, so we got a pig on the. I got a bit of pork finally for the fire now. A bit of pork for the fire now. It was a bit mummy when I shot it too. Got a bit, ratchet, but oh well, that's what we came to do, eh? That's what we came to do finally. It's a quiet night. It's overcast. Oh yeah, a few spits. I should probably actually start getting a tarpaulin up. Yeah, I will. I'm gonna start getting a tarpaulin up. Finally. Enjoy this beautiful meal. Give thanks for this beautiful day. Sitting here by the fire. My mates are still not back yet. They'll be walking along the bush edge, I'd say. As the fire slowly starts to die down. Got the big log. Gonna slow burn it. I think my mates are staying out for the night. I think they're staying out for the night finally. I've been through about 3 big logs. Got the koi ready for them for when they turn up. Got a bit of a garlic bread on there. But I think I'm just about ready to hit the sack. I wanted it to be nice and warm for when they got back, but I think my mates have decided to park up for the night somewhere in the bush. But I can just feel the cold, man. It's gonna be cold. They don't have their sleeping bags. They don't have a change of warm pair of clothes. All they've got is the 2-3 dogs. So I'm assuming they're gonna be cuddling up with those dogs tonight, because she's muckadiddy fine, eh? And unless they keep the fire burning all night, I hope it doesn't rain on them. I hope my mates are safe, they'll be alright. Probably my last little vlog for the night. Not a bad day whānau. Ka kite.
Well, it's the next morning whānau. I get up early and go off on a bit of a hunt there. My mates still haven't turned up, they've roughed it overnight, so I make my way up the track for a little bit of a scope to see if I can bump into anything. But this next day, I don't do much filming because I've been thrashing my camera and the battery's starting to get kind of low. So my mates finally turn up. They turn up about mid-afternoon, maybe about 2:30. They actually caught me having a snooze. I was having a bit of a snooze in the old tent, and I heard the voices turn up, and then I woke up and I came out, and sure enough, my mates were back. They were buggered. They were stuffed, whānau. They were buggered. Still had the there was still ashes on the fire, so the fire was still quite warm, and it was they sat down and I just got up and I got the billy on. The koi was still in the pot from the night before, and I warmed that up for them. And then just made sure that they were all right, because when they got back, they told me what had happened. And what had actually happened was,
so you first went up that when that we were looking across, eh?
Yeah, straight up that ridge, that you could see the tall trees on there.
Yeah.
We followed that big south marker. I followed it up. I didn't think she would be that far over, eh? But I think what happened was, when we got up there, the spider chased some deer just as we got on top,
oh, yeah,
and pushed her, disturbed her, eh?
Yeah.
and then I went down, I crossed over those little guts where we came up, and I on the comedy, and I had a look at the ground, and it was bloody everywhere, bloody everywhere. So we cut left, big ridges running down. So we, bloody dogs took off. I thought it was a deer, because he was only spider gave three or four yep yeps. All of a sudden I heard snow. I said to my mate, they got it. But it was sounded a long way off. Anyway, when we got it, I knew we were late. Didn't have much. We had about half an hour to dark.
Wow, really?
We got it about a half an hour.
And it was already—it's already dark in the bush, eh?
Yeah. And I
tried to jump
by the birds. The birds give a night call.
Oh,
and I thought to myself, well, normally when you hear that, it's about 20 minutes, half an hour, and it's dark. When they change tone, which is what they call. I said, well, mate, shit, we better hurry up and get this fire going. He said, I'm going to go to that step. I went to that step and I'm going to take off. Into this pig is too beautiful condition to do that. And it would have been harder to carry like that, would have flopped all over the place. Yeah. But the knot went quite quick, actually.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Yes, to me, anyway, it went quite fast.
Then the big journey began the next day.
The next day, he said, oh, we're not too far away, cousin. But it was a good track, though. It was open, eh? When I saw one of the trees, I had a trap on it, and I thought, shit, it was a long way in. I remember this tree, eh?
Yeah.
I wrapped it quite a way. I didn't say anything to my mate. I thought, keep his energy levels up, just keep quiet. And he goes, are we there yet?
Yeah.
Shit, we're only about an hour from my other cabin. That's a long way up.
That were actually about 6 hours from that. 6 hours walk from the edge of the bush. So it's now the Saturday and we've decided to go for a bit of a hikoi up the track and then cut back further inland. So the plan is I take off up ahead with the dogs and they're gonna meet me further up.
Spider, and we're off on a little bit of a hikoi. We're gonna walk up the track to the end of here, then we're gonna cut in. And we're going to go for a hunt right back into one of Papa's old stomping grounds. Have a look out there. Hopefully bump into a bit of pork.
There's a distinct place in there where there's these massive big rata tree and this awesome this like root system that's grown in kind of like a gate sort of looking thing. I'll show you, you'll see photos, you should be seeing photos right now. And so we're gonna meet there, that's the posse, and that's about maybe an hour and a half, 2 hours into the bush. And if you don't know where you're going, you won't find it. So I'm gonna get there and wait for them, and then they're gonna turn up, and then we're gonna start our hikoi. So my mates finally turned up. They turned up, and then Papa takes us off on another journey up one of his other tracks. We decide to start looping back around and coming back towards the river and towards the track to head back to our camp. It's cold, it's showery, and then the sun comes out and then it's showering again. It's really, really out of it weather. And probably around 2:30, 3 o'clock, Papa starts having some difficulties with his heart and with his blood flow, and he starts getting quite nauseous and has to sit down really quite often. So we start slowing down the pace and we just really make sure that we take care of him on the way there. He soldiers on like a bloomin', I don't know, like a young fella. Uncle Harry keeps saying he thinks we're 21 again.
No sweat. No sweat.
Going across, I go,
oh, he thinks we're 21. So he's just pushing through and then he's hanging on the tree and he's hanging there. Got his head and he's just about fainting, and then he sits down, and then I come up, you're alright, Pop? Yeah, I'm alright. Sit down for about 5 minutes, 10 minutes, back up onto his feet, and then slowly chugging away with this. And anyway, we finally make it. Took like hours. Took hours. Finally make it back down to the track that is going to head around towards the track back to our camp. We both make a decision that I'm going to head up the river and I'm going to see if I can bang into something further up the river. I was just going to take my gun and he was going to take the dogs back. I was going to try to get a deer. I branched off and I went down towards the river and they carried on around the side back to our camp. I sort of come up and I start hunting the river. And there's a few good clearings down there and you can get a pretty good view from some of the points. So I snuck up to these points and I had a look over at this at these clearings. Sure enough, there was like a mob of hinds out there, but they were like sharp and the wind was pretty swirly. It wasn't coming at my face, so it was sort of all over the place. And as soon as I popped my head up over this this little rise to have a look out onto this clearing, they were already like had their ears in the air. They were looking in my direction, and I was busted. Boom! They were gone. They bolted. So that was a bit ratchet. And then I had a good look around on a few other good clearings down there, and there was big mobs. There was some good mobs of deer down there. I'd never had a good stalk on them. So, and I'm not a long shooter. I'm just not confident personally shooting long distance. So I'll rather stalk up and get as close as I can and then take the shot. I hate those ones where you shoot long distance and you wound them, or you know. So anyway, I pass on these deer. I pass on a few other deer, and then I get to this point and it's kind of like it's been late. It's a long day, whānau. It's been a long day, and it's late afternoon. It's about 4 o'clock. And it's overcast and it's getting kind of dark. So I sort of stand there at this bend and I think to myself, fuck, I'm actually kind of over it. And can go back to our base camp and have a hot drink and a sit down and a bit of kai to eat, because I hadn't eaten anything all day. Didn't have any breakfast. Just charging on a bloody coffee in the morning. And that pure whey that comes out of the creeks and the rivers. That's sweet, man. That's the goodness. That's the purity. And anyway, I get to this point, and I'm standing there, and I'm looking back at our camp, and I'm looking, do I go further or do I head back? Anyway, when I asked myself that question, I had this flooding feel, this flooding vision of there being pigs, and I just had this feeling that there were pigs around the corner, or there was a pig somewhere. So I sort of like, I trusted in what I was feeling, and I thought, okay, I'll just have a look around this corner. And sure enough, whānau, I come around this bend and I have a look further off down. There's quite a flat clearing way off in the distance, and I had a look around the corner and here's a pig. There's a nice good sized pig way down on this little clearing, and I'm blown away. I'm like, fucking massive. So then you know, the old adrenaline starts pumping again. I figure out, you know, okay, I need to make my move quick. I need to make it now. It's getting dark. Which way is the wind coming? What direction is the pig heading? He was heading away from me, so you know, I needed to make my move then and there. So I started hustling. I hustled pretty quick and I bolted down through this thing, cut around through the riverbed, and I made sure to stick close to the riverbed because you know, the natural sound of the river sort of masks your footsteps and any little sticks or something that you might be breaking. So use that to your advantage. And so I'm hugging this riverbed, but I'm making sure to notice where the wind's going and notice what direction it's going as well. I get closer, and then I get to a point where I feel like, okay, if I make any sounds or moves, sudden moves, and drop some shit or whatever, I'm gonna be busted. So I took my oil skin off, I took my belt off, just like that last pig, and I just went into stalk mode. Got the old stalk mode activated on, and took my boots off, took my leggings off, took my oilskin jacket off, took my belt off, and I just had my camera and my rifle. And then I was off. You gotta tell yourself, you know, you gotta slow down. because you can get really excited when you're chasing animals, and you know, it's just a thrill, whanau. Slow yourself down, even the breathing and the sweating. You know, the more you sweat, the more you perspirate, the more scent you're going to give off as well. So just calm yourself down, a few deep breaths, and just cruise. Where this pig was, I had to sort of like maneuver my way around through this thick scrubby shit along the riverbed to get to a point where I could actually see where he was. And I hear all of this trotting through the river, and I'm thinking, ah, fuck. And then I come out and have a quick look around another bend, and all these deer just running across the river back into the bush. I actually thought I'd been busted. I thought, well, if the deer could smell me, then that pig's gone too. So I carry on a little bit, feeling a little bit disheartened, and I'm just sort of like walking along the riverbed. And I look up further down, and there's a bit of a face there. And on this face, there's these two pigs, and they're just doing their thing, and they're just rooting up the ground, and I'm standing out in the middle of the river, mean. So then I made a decision, and I looked at which way they were heading. So they were heading back into the bush. So I sort of decided to cut across the river and head in a direction where I could set up and be ready for when they walk into my vision. So I did my plan. I went and I set up my thing, had my camera, and I was doing all this filming. And I set up on this nice little comfortable platform, and I just waited. And I waited. Next minute, this pig, there was another pig, and he came sidling down from the top. And it was a good, nice, probably about a three and a half year old boar. And he was in good nick. He came down, and I watched him, and I thought, mean. And he dropped down onto this track. And then he started coming around. I turned my scope up as close as it could go, so I could identify which one was the boar. I found him, and he was walking along there with this, it was a nice young sow too. But I found him, and I was following him across. He stopped to have a little root in the ground, so I lined him up on his, just behind the neck, and pulled the trigger, and he dropped right there. Now I had this pig, so I gutted him out, cleaned him up in the river, washed his guts out, and nice fat pig. Like I said, I got footage of all of this, and I had my camera on, and it was working footage. Chucked him on, and missioned back to where my gear were, and got my shit on, and by this time it was starting to get really quite late, starting to get quite dark. So I hit the bush edge, and it was pitch black. I just had my head torch, so I start making my way up this face. It's pitch black. I don't know if you've ever walked around in the bush at night time, it's fucking dark as. And anyway, I'm going up these spurs, and I know that your track is in this sort of general direction. I finally hit the right track, and I start making my way back around, following this track back to where my mates were. On the way there, there's all these beautiful glowworms, and they're like jotted all through the sides of the banks, and it was so beautiful. End up making it back to camp that night. It was about maybe 2.5 hours to where our camp was, maybe even 3 hours. But I finally got there, and this is probably pretty much the only footage of that pig that I've got.
So you singed a pig on the fire, aren't it?
Another kid?
Yeah. What's the weight you can lie on here?
Okay.
You won't put the fire and bring it around this way.
Oh yeah.
What's up? Yeah. 7 minutes. Green wood there, I'll set him up in here and won't check the fire.
Yeah.
Right, camp loaded, pork packed, we're away, whānau. A very successful, awesome mission with my grandfather and my uncle, and really, really blessed going home with a pig each and ready to share it out with some of the whānau. Coming up next is what I've done with my pig that I took back home. So stay tuned, whānau. I think you're going to really enjoy the end.
Cheerio, whānau! Yeehaw! I'm on my way down to the park. Got all the cooking gears, got the barbecue, got the... Ooh, we better take our time. I got a very precious load on the back there, whānau. We got the old wild pork boil up, so we'll just creep it then. I'm on my way down to the local park here in Gisborne. if you've watched the whole video up until this point, congratulations. It was a long watch, but we're off to feed some hungry people. We're off to just share the love and share the kai at the park today, whānau, and just connect with a lot of people and see where we can take this pork further than what it just into my puku. So stay tuned, whānau, and I'll keep you up to date. Cheer. Check it out, whānau, we've arrived. Check this beautiful location out. Look at this place. I'm looking forward to connecting with different people and just sharing this beautiful wild pork that you've seen if you've been still watching this video. This is part of the journey, whānau, is feeding the whānau and connecting people. This is going to be a massive experience, whānau. I can't wait to get set up and just start waving people down. Come for a kai, you know what I mean? Let's get into it. If I could have more time, we would brainstorm. And I love you tender, but we must walk away. Keeping you on my greeting card file. And if it were different, but you know it ain't. Let's get on with it, love. Call me loyal. I'll say hello. Here we are down here, all the whānau.
Still got heaps of the old potatoes. Still got heaps of watercress in there. Bones. One of the sisters bought us a nice mean mint stew. Read it out for us, cuz.
Free kai, let's unite. Yee-haw.
Free kai, let's unite.
Look at that, whānau. Why not? Let's bring everyone together. Let's break down those boundaries.
Beautiful. Just love it. Love bringing people together. This is what life is about, whānau. Jump on board.
Leave it that way, baby. We are loyal. Haven't you known me long enough?
Well, that's a wrap, whānau. Awesome, awesome, beautiful evening. This video has been going for a while, but
I'm glad that you've joined in, and I'm really happy that you've lasted this long if you have. I'm going to leave now, but I'm going to leave with one message, and that is love is the most powerful force in the universe, whānau. From the centre of my being to you, my friend, thank you for watching, thank you for joining, and thank you for connecting with me. Thank you for spending your time watching this video. If you've really enjoyed it, if you feel like you would like to get into this sort of mahi, get on this sort of kaupapa, contact me, message me. Let's organise something, let's talk, let's chat, let's create. If you've enjoyed this as well, share this video if you want, you know, like, let's spread the message on uniting people together and bringing everyone together. Let's stop being so separate and start becoming as one people, and seeing people as brothers and sisters rather than strangers. Let's bring everyone together, whānau. Like I said, if you've enjoyed this video and if you want to carry on following these journeys, I'm going to be going on a lot more journeys like this, whānau. So if you've enjoyed this, subscribe, share this video, like this video, do whatever you want to do to help me spread this positive message so that more people can see the next video that comes out. It's exciting, whānau. I'm ready for this new intuitive path that I'm about to embark on, and I want to bring as many people as I can with me. So come along for the ride, whānau. Sign up on Patreon, and anything helps along this journey. Lots of love, whānau, from me, from the center of my being to you right now, my friend. Thank you very much for your time, thank you for watching, and spread the message. It's all love. Cheers, whānau.